If you have 20 minutes for yourself, let's paint these beautiful watercolor poppies together. I will guide you step by step and you will create an amazing art for your home. These are the supplies you will need: cold pressed paper approximately of A4 size, a masking tape and a round brush of 8 or 12 size with fine tip. I used lots of warm and cold red color mixtures. As usual, I will link all the supplies I used in the video description. First, you need to stretch a masking tape, then your artwork will have clean borders. I will start painting each poppy from the pistil. It will be my guide to shape the rest of the flower. I will paint two circles of stamens using cadmium yellow and lemon yellow. Now I'm adding red to my yellow mixture to paint the first petal. Make sure you do not paint with a dry brush. If you do, then add water to your brush strokes. Cold pressed paper drinks a lot of water, so make sure your mixtures are watery enough. Now we'll paint another petal using cadmium yellow dip. I'm painting it with almost transparent mixture. For each petal, we will use several colors to make them look super bright and saturated. Now we'll add opera rose to a transparent petal to create beautiful color bleed. When we are alternating warm and cold tones, it shows that the light hits various petals differently. We will use super intense red for the next petal. I am mixing it with orange. Okay, let's paint with opera rose again and add some water. I'm adding a quinacridone rose to this petal to show the folds. And the last pattern will be light orange. Now let's add dark colors to show the shadows and to add depth to the flower. I'm mixing red with brown and quinacridone rose for this. Let's mix indigo with sap green dip and add details to the pistil. I'm adding some shadow with a brown color. I'm switching to the bigger brush. Mine is size 12. I think it will let me paint the petals faster. Let's check if it works. Again, let's start from the pistil. I will use a mix of red and orange colors for the first petal. Don't forget to paint a part of each petal with half transparent mixture. It will add depth to the painting. Change warm and cold tones. Now I'm painting with opera rose mixed with water. While the color is wet, add darker tones to outline the petal folds. You can see that first my brush was dry and now I added more water to my mixture and the result is much better. Before painting this illustration, I found some poppies references on Pinterest, and now I'm looking at them while painting to see which color should the petals be. Petals underneath the flower on the left should be darker, as they are located in the shadow, so I paint them using dark mixtures. I'm adding dark stamens to the center of the flower. Let's do the same with the first flower. As the paint dries, it becomes lighter, so I'm adding new layers of the paint. These flowers should look super bright and colorful. I want to paint the third flower in much lighter colors. I will use opera rose and yellow ochre mixed with lots of water for this. I must say that the bigger brush of 12 size works great to paint these flowers. I could definitely paint the whole painting using only one brush like this. While the petals are wet, add darker strokes to show the folds. Also, this is the perfect time to add details to the center of this poppy. The petals, which are in the shadow, should be darker, so let's add darker color to them. The next flower will be placed at an angle, so the petals should be painted differently. Some of them will be longer and the bottom ones will be shorter. It will give them a more concave look. This flower will be in warm yellow and orange tones. I start painting with an intense color mixture and then I am adding water to it. Otherwise, the flower will look flat. Please do leave white areas inside each petal. Thus, they will look more natural and real. I'm adding yellow dots in the center to define it. The new flower will be partially hidden behind the first flower, so we will see only the top of it. To paint the folds, I'm using quinacridone rose. I'm adding brown to it to paint darker areas. I want to highlight the centers of the flowers, so I'm adding dark green dots to them. To paint such important details, it's better to look at the real flower photos while painting. The last flower will look down. Its top part will be warm and the bottom one will be cold. I will use warm red and opera rose to paint them. I decided to add some greens to my painting to make the red colors pop even more. You know that red and green colors are complementary, so when placed near each other they create high contrast. I'm using my favorite dagger brush for this, but really you can use the same brush you used to paint the flowers. I'm filling the empty space. We can leave the painting as it is now and it will look finished. We could leave the painting as it is now and it will look finished. Or we can add more layers to it to make it look more eye-catching, more colorful and saturated. This is what I'll be doing during the next 5 minutes. I will search for the areas where I could add shadow, increase the contrast or make the colors look more intense. If some strokes are too sharp, simply soften them with the brush full of clean water. Use more bright mixtures of orange, opera rose and red colors. The petals behind the flower make more dark and define the center of each flower with some details.
Thank you.
Okay, the painting is finished. Let's remove the masking tape. We have beautiful clean borders which make this artwork look very professional. Now I will show you my first painting of these poppies, which I made while I was practicing before filming this tutorial. I used the same references, same supplies, but the result is still different. This always happens when you paint loosely without a pencil sketch. You never know how the final art will look, and that is quite amazing. Please don't forget to share your art with me by tagging me in your Instagram posts or stories. I will be very happy to see how you coped with this painting.